So now let's talk about the virtues of this linked list-based queuing lock. Some of the virtues are exactly similar to the Anderson's queuing lock, and that is, it is fair. So Anderson's lock was also fair, ticket lock was also fair, the linked list queuing lock is also fair. And again, the spin location is unique for every spinner, right? Every spinner has a unique spin location to wait on. And so that is similar to the Anderson's queue lock as well. And that's good because you're not causing contention on the network when the lock is released. When one guy releases the lock, others, if they're waiting, they don't get bothered by the signal. And exactly one processor gets signaled when the lock is released. That's also good. And usually, there's only one atomic operation per critical section. And the only thing that happens is this corner case. In order to implement this corner case, you have to use a second atomic operation. But if the linked list has several members, in this examples, I'm just showing only two requesters at a time. But if the linked list has a number of requesters, then if I'm middle of the gang using the lock, I simply signal the successor. I don't have to do anything fancy in terms of compare and swap. So this is something that needs to be done only for the corner case, not as a routine for doing the unlock operation. And the other good thing that we already mentioned is that the space complexity of this data structure is proportional to the number of requesters to the lock at any point of time. So it is dynamic. It's not statically defined as in the array-based queuing lock. And so that's one of the biggest virtues of this particular algorithm, that the space complexity is bound by the number of dynamic requests to a particular lock and not the size of the multiprocessor itself. Now, the downside to this linked list-based queuing lock is, of course, the fact that there is linked list maintenance overhead that is associated with making a lock request or unlock request. And Anderson's array-based queue lock, because it's an array data structure, can be slightly faster than this linked list-based algorithm. And one of the things that I should mention there is that both Anderson's array-based queue lock as well as the MCS linked list-based queue lock may result in poorer performance if the architecture does not support fancy instructions like this, because they have to be simulated using test and set. So that can be a little detriment to this particular algorithms as well. We have discussed different algorithms for implementing locks in a shared memory multiprocessor. If the processor has some form of a fetch and fee operation, then the two flavors of queue-based locks, both due to Anderson and MCS, they are a good bet for scalability. If, on the other hand, the processor only has test and set, then an exponential backoff algorithm would be a good bet for scalability.